So how do we balance that idea of AI, automation, and you know, robots and whatever, with our human-centric approach? So yes, we can leverage our AI enhancements. We can take AI to make us a better project manager. So if we look at the pieces of project management, where I'm not necessarily interacting with others, creating reports, creating plans, creating documents, analyzing data, that's prime for AI. But when we look at the big chunk of project management, communications, face-to-face meetings, hallway meetings, ad hoc, my behavior towards others and others' behavior towards me, that you can't fake that with AI. That's where we need the emotional intelligence. So we want to continue to nurture our human-centric approach. So yes, AI, it can make us more efficient. It can help us make better decisions based on data. It can help us automate processes, get rid of bureaucracy. But when it comes to things like emotions and the psychological needs, not that we're all psychiatrists, but sometimes it feels that way as a project manager, you can't do that with AI, not effectively, at least not yet in our time. So we have to continue to have emotional intelligence to make that human connection is what's needed in project management. And that goes all the way back to one of the first definitions of project management, that projects are a temporary endeavor completed by people to create a unique product, service, or result. So we still have to have people. As much as we can fall in love with AI, I don't know if you fall in love with it, but much as you might like AI, we still need the people factor, the human factor. Now, I'm all in favor of being more efficient. In my organization, it's all about efficiency. How can we streamline repetitive tasks? How can we leverage things to get done faster, but to get done with better quality, with more control, with more reliability, with more repeatable processes? You know my opinion on this, I've said it several times, that AI cannot do everything. We have to have the people involved. We have to have the people actually do the work. But I think that we can use AI to automate project processes. We've already seen this, analyzing vast amounts of data. Like all of my training is being learned by AI to be kind of this PM coach and to answer questions and so on. It can identify patterns. You think about your work patterns. So if we go back in time, we think about a control chart where it's a stable process and it's showing the performance of that process and does it dip below, out of control, or is it above control? At some point it's out of our control limits. Well, AI could analyze that and see what's happening or predicting when that's likely to happen again. Just like we're seeing with weather patterns, trying to do some predictability with weather patterns. So anything that has a repeatable process, AI can probably analyze and look for ways to forecast or ways to improve our project workflows. So AI can optimize our processes. Let's look at our high value activities. Well, what's a high value activity? A high value activity is tied directly to the core business value, the reason why we're doing this. I think a lot of project managers, probably none of you, but a lot of project managers may feel the point of doing a project is to have project management, where you know they probably cuddle with the PMBOK at night, that oh, they just love every all these 49 processes and the inputs and tools and techniques, and that's not the point of doing a project. The point of doing a project is to create business value by understanding why we're doing this project. How does it align with our strategic mission? How does it align with the wants and needs of our customers or stakeholders? That's where we find the business value. So we have these activities in a project that are tied directly or very closely to creating that business value. We want to become risk averse. We don't want to threaten the value attached to these high value activities. We don't want to threaten the value of the things that are contributing to the business value. So AI can help us focus on protecting and really guarding those high value activities. And then just repeating the repetitive task automating any repetitive tasks. So data entry, reporting, scheduling, any of that stuff that you have to do over and over and over, that's prime for AI. So go out and use AI to create some VB scripts or PowerShell or whatever you want. You can really have AI do about anything when it comes to coding to create a way to automate those type of redundant, boring, non-value, I won't say non-value add, but they're not as valuable as other activities in the project. I'm a big fan of the 80-20 principle, that about 20% of our value, or 80% of our value comes from about 20% of our work. So let's do more of this. If it's not tied to creating the value, then it's not as important. Now I know some of you are probably saying, well, you have to do everything in the project. Well, of course you do, but there are some places that I put more energy, more focus than others, because I want to focus on creating and protecting that business value. So AI can help us to automate and optimize our project processes. We think about cycle time and lead time, improve our resource utilization. You think about how many hours are in an ideal day versus a reality. So we can, you know, play what ifs. Well, what if they actually did get 8 true hours as opposed to, you know, more reality, maybe 6 hours? What if we got rid of the senior engineer doing these low value activities? And how would that help maximize our schedule? And just working towards overall project performance, like when it comes to time, cost, and quality. So here's a couple of examples. Every day there's something new that comes up. I just got an email this morning about Microsoft Copilot, how it's gonna remember everything that I've ever done on my computer. That sounds a little scary. But this is one that's pretty cool. It's called fellow.app. And I'm sure by tomorrow there'll be a whole new one out there for you. But I like this because it can do meeting transcriptions. So no one ever likes to have to do the transcription in a meeting or have to take the notes in the meeting. So Fellow can do record that and write the minutes down and so on. But who's gonna read it? But it has a documentation, so our meeting minutes. And there's some other cool things that it can do as well. So it can create a little summary for a post meeting, for follow-ups and action items. You can help automate that. I thought that's pretty neat. Then we have timely.app. So this is where if you have to work on several projects, you can do automatic time tracking based on the type of work that you're doing. There's a little project dashboard. And there's also a little memory tracker, so you want to quickly recall things. Where did I store that or where did I do it? And then you can do timesheets in here based on the automatic time tracking of which project I'm working on and how do I build my time. So that was would have been very helpful to me when I was consulting. I was consulting at State Farm, and I was actually managing about 30 projects at once. But they were all very small, like a week to 4 weeks. But every time one was completed, a new one would come in. So it was this constant flow of this chunk of projects. But I had to keep track of how much time I spent on each project as a PM. And so it got to be pretty hectic. Well, this could have been really neat at that time, but that was years ago. I didn't have hair then either, but it was years ago. Streamline decision-making with AI, using data to help us make good decisions. Having actionable insights. So we use AI and then we have to act on it. So people have to act on those results. And then like I talked about earlier, about doing some predictive analytics for risk, for quality, time and cost, doing like Monte Carlo or what if scenarios. Now I'm a big fan of this idea, and I think we're gonna see more of this with AI and project management. And I hinted at this with decision-making with AI. So based on what's happened in the project so far, like you relate here, what is that going to do the remainder of the project? How will you What gives and takes will you have to do in order to hit milestones, like work overtime or add more labor? And then we have these different algorithms with forecasting. Again, what ifs, but we could play, here's what's actually happened, but what if we did this? What if we tweaked the project this way? And then looking for risk, and then looking for what's the best course of action, like a decision tree that AI could help us build out, or to have actual values for probability. So, you know, 80% probable, 20% not, or what have you. But lead us to good decisions, like a decision tree is. We want to streamline decision making. I hinted at this earlier about waiting time is wasted time. So by using AI, can that help us respond quicker to what's happening in our project? Can we capitalize on new opportunities in the marketplace? Can we mitigate risk? So all of these I've hinted at. I think those are things that we can do right now with AI. AI project efficiency, can we reduce costs? Everyone's interested in reducing costs. All projects come down to just two things. No matter what industry or life you're in, all projects come down to two things. You are going to reduce costs, or you're going to increase revenue. That's the why, when you keep asking why five times, that it's gonna come down to increasing revenue or reducing costs. So based on that, how can we use AI to hit that core business value? How can we improve our project outcomes? And then what can we do to make people happy? Think about that stakeholder engagement matrix. How can we leverage AI in EI there?